Now, coming to the one of the most recent advances for aortic stenosis, that is transcatheter aortic valve replacement. It is called TAVI also, where it comes for transcatheter aortic valve implantation. Symptomatic patient with severe AS have a poor prognosis. The mortality at 1 year in medically treated patient is almost 50%. Whenever the aortic stenosis patient is symptomatic, it itself proves that the patient has severe aortic stenosis. TAVI was previously indicated for severe AS who cannot undergo surgery, like something like porcelain aorta, prior radiation therapy, frailty with old age, severe hepatic or pulmonary disease. But now TAVI is being employed for patient with aortic stenosis, even who are posted as moderate risk. They don't reserve only for high risk surgical patient. Even in moderate risk patient, TAVI is being employed. TAVR is not inferior but not statistically superior to surgical replacement in low risk patient. In spite of that, FDA gave the approval for TAVI in low risk surgical population also. Since its introduction, lot of technical advancement are made in the development of TAVI procedure, and it evolved rapidly where TAVI is being done everywhere now. The TAVI is associated with both short-term as well as long-term complication. This includes mortality. Remember, you are dealing with an aortic stenosis with various comorbidity under an elderly patient. Stroke, permanent pacemaker insertion where you disturb the conduction system, vascular complication, you are dealing with the aorta, valve embolization, some calcium near the aortic valve, renal failure, cardiac rupture, aortic rupture, cardiac tamponade and bleeding. These are all the various short-term as well as long-term complication of TAVR. The multidisciplinary team involves cardiologists, cardiac surgeon, cardiac anesthesiologist, perfusionist is very important. Your pump has to be on standby, intensivist in the post-operative care, nurses and other people. The hybrid operating room or cardiac catheterization laboratory should have adequate space. You need TE probe, you need cardiopulmonary bypass, you need space to assemble the valve, and you need anesthesia machine to anesthetize and give general anesthesia, and you have a screen for imaging also, so it should have adequate space. That is very, very important. Emergency supply of all the necessary drugs including inotrope, support from fellow colleagues, perfusionists and cardiac surgeon, and immediate access to cardiopulmonary bypass should be always available. The most important requirement is the vascular access to the aortic valve annulus. Here you have a cath lab with the imaging modality. Initially you do a coronary angiogram if the need rises, see whether the patient has absolutely normal anatomy for TAVI. You do the baseline assessment with the echocardiogram, assess the aortic annulus, everything. This will be done in pre-op also, and in intraoperative during starting the procedure also it will be reassessed. Then through the femoral artery, you cross the aorta, aortic valve, and the aortic annulus is crossed, then the valve is implanted. So you do a baseline assessment, get the vascular access, take the valve inside the aortic annulus, inflate the valve, and the valve is open. These are the usual steps. Blood from LA goes into LV, the aortic valve is normal, and it goes into the systemic circulation. This is the normal circulation. Your aortic valve holds normally. Now you have a stenotic aortic valve. Now the blood from the left ventricle cannot pass into the, here you can see large amount of blood, but only thin amount goes into the aorta. There is a stenotic aortic valve. So to access it retrogradely, you pass a catheter along the femoral artery. Here it passes through the femoral artery, descending aorta, arch of aorta, then comes to the ascending aorta, cross the aortic valve. You pass a catheter there. This is called the retrograde approach. Now, this is the stenotic valve here. Initially, you do a balloon valvoplasty, open up the aortic valve. Now you bring the transcutaneous aortic valve here. You can see that the valve is being placed here and the catheter is removed. Now the aortic valve is opened up. Now if you look at the circulation, the valve is open so the LV blood can go into the systemic circulation. No more reduced cardiac output, and your gradient between the left ventricle and the aorta will be grossly reduced. You can see the valve in position of the aortic stenosis. If you compare with before and after, here you can see a stenosis valve when the gradient is around 60. Now you have placed the aortic valve and the gradient has reduced to 10 to 15 and the cardiac output is maintained.